Hey everyone, Paul Bowden here from the Office of Mac team. Welcome to Building 36 here out of Redmond, Washington, the home of office engineering. Every week we aim to bring you, the deployment insiders, the best practices, tips, tricks for managing and deploying Office 365 ProPlus. Today I'm going to talk to you about converting existing Mac users who have an Office 2016 or 2019 volume license to an Office 365 ProPlus subscription. As you'll see, there are really three simple steps for accomplishing this, and it really is very straightforward and non-disruptive for your users. So let's get started. So there are three steps that you need to follow to convert existing users from VL to Office 365. The first is to verify which build and which license those users currently have. The second is to download and install the license removal tool. And then the third is to reactivate Office on that computer. So first of all, I'm going to walk through this process manually, such as what you would do in a white glove scenario on this computer. And then what we'll do is we'll talk about how you would automate these processes for the rest of your fleet. Okay, so I have Word here. I'm gonna go into the About box, which is the source of truth. And here I can see that the license is volume license 2019, which is great. I can also see which build I'm running here. Here I can see 1904, which is a April 2019 build. So this one is also relatively up to date. I'm also going to pull down the font menu here because one of my litmus tests to see whether I'm on volume license or not is to look for cloud fonts. Okay, now on to step two. We need to download and run the license removal tool. You can download the tool from the Microsoft network from aka.ms/LRT. So once downloaded, the license removal tool should exist in your downloads folder. You can simply run that up, and here we see a warning. It's good for all types of volume licenses. I just need to go and accept the license agreement, click install, and I need to make sure that all of the existing Office applications are closed. So let's go ahead and do that here. Okay, I need to type in my admin credentials, and you should find that the tool only takes between 5 and 10 seconds to complete. And here we can see success. So let's go ahead and close. So finally, step three, we now need to reactivate Office. Okay, so this is as simple as just launching any of the applications. Here I'm gonna launch Word, and I'm gonna type in my Office 365 username and hit next. And now I can just type in my password. And I should just be able to sign in and reactivate Office. So that's looking good. Let's go and check the About box just to make sure that everything worked correctly. And yep, we can see Office 365 subscription right here. So I've now successfully reactivated Office, and hey, now I can see my cloud fonts in my font menu. Okay, so what about all of the other Office apps? Well, that bit is straightforward because all you have to do is launch them. Because Office apps share the keychain, they'll dynamically detect that the license is back in place again. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward for just a single user, but what if you want to convert your entire fleet of computers? How can you automate this? Well, if you have a tool such as Jamf Pro, it's pretty easy. I have some sample extension attributes on my GitHub that you can use to show additional Office information in the inventory. Here I'm showing the version identifier for each of the Office apps along with the license that is being used on that machine. And here's my 2019 volume license. You can upload the license removal tool to Jamf Pro and then create a self-service policy so that users can execute the conversion by themselves. So users can open the self-service catalog and see an icon here for performing the conversion. Now I'd normally give them a warning here to make sure that they save all documents before proceeding. The license removal tool is going to go shut down all of the Office applications automatically, so that's why we give them that warning. And so it's just finishing up here. Again, should only take a few seconds and it's done. When the user goes back to launch another Office application, they'll get into that sign-in workflow. So there you go, three easy steps for converting a volume license to Office 365. I hope you found that video informative. If you did, click the thumbs up button below and make sure you hit subscribe to receive notifications for new videos in the future. If you have any questions, you can hit me up on the Microsoft Office channel on MacAdmin Slack. Take care and see you next time.